folks. I'm Hub Arkush for ChicagoSunTimes.com. And normally, we would be reviewing the Bears game this past Sunday, but reviewing the Bears' disaster at Lambeau Field Sunday night against the Green Bay Packers, well, it doesn't make much sense now. Everybody knows it was horrible. It was embarrassing. There's really nothing to talk about football-wise. The Chicago Bears had a systemic failure. They were terrible on offense. They were terrible on defense. Special teams were awful. A lot of people wondering, has this team quit, or did they quit Sunday night on their coaching staff, on their organization, in their city? I was working the sidelines for the Westwood One National Radio broadcast, and I can tell you, no, they didn't quit. There were players invested, involved, players trying to rally their teammates. They certainly were there trying not to embarrass themselves any worse than they did. But at the end of the day, this is a football team that is not responding to its coaching staff. They're not responding to each other. They don't have anyone stepping up and making plays. And so rather than review the disaster was at the Packer game, probably the best thing to do is to take a look forward and say, what can they salvage the remaining 7 weeks of the season? Remember, five of them are at home. Certainly the playoffs would always be a possibility if they could win out. But talking about this team winning out would be silly. The question seems to be, will they win again? They've got two with the Vikings. They've got two with Detroit. They've got a chance to maybe get healthy in the division. But those teams are playing much better football than the Chicago Bears. What has to happen next for them? The first thing is a bunch of veterans need to look in the mirror and decide, are we doing everything we possibly can? Jay Cutler is taking the brunt of the heat. Jay Cutler had another bad game Sunday night against the Green Bay Packers, but Jay Cutler didn't lose that football game by himself. The offensive line allowed him to be sacked four times. His wide receivers, well, Brandon Marshall played pretty well in the second half, but that was about it. Martellus Bennett gets points for being heroic and showing up playing hurt. He tried to play through bruised ribs. You could tell he was limited a little bit. On the defensive side of the ball, it was mainly Jared Allen who was going up and down the line, up and down the sidelines, trying to get everybody involved in the game. He himself got close to Aaron Rodgers a couple times, but close doesn't count in football. The rest of the defensive line, basically no pressure. The secondary was flat out awful. We keep hearing about defensive coordinator Mel Tucker, people saying we need a change there. When defensive backs don't cover, there's not much the defensive coordinator can do. Yeah, you probably do need a coaching change, but when are these players going to start to respond to the coaching that they're getting? They were broken coverages repeatedly Sunday night against the Green Bay Packers. That's the only way even Aaron Rodgers can throw six touchdown passes in the first half. So really, it's not about football at this point. Most people still believe there is talent on the Chicago Bears football team. When will they decide to start playing again? Are they embarrassed enough? You would think back-to-back performances like New England and Green Bay would get somebody angry. Could the Minnesota Vikings this coming Sunday be the victim of the Bears' anger? Well, that's what Bears fans have to hope for. That's what Bears players are hoping for. But the bottom line is, can these coaches get it turned? It is the coaches the players are not responding to right now. It's the question all the fans are asking, all the media is asking. This is a huge week for Mark Trestman, Aaron Cromer, Mel Tucker, that entire staff. If the Bears fail to show up again on Sunday against the Vikings after these two embarrassments, you have to start to ask the question, does it make any sense to continue on with this coaching staff? Nobody wants to deal with that in the middle of the season. Nobody thought it would come this quickly, but we've definitely reached the crisis point for Mark Trestman and his regime with the Chicago Bears. For all the best coverage of the Bears and sports all the time, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, make sure you stay right where you're at Chicagosuntimes.com.